Hello and welcome to Love My Poland. You know, I am fully convinced that the clear sign that you've fallen in love with a country and its native language happens when you hear that language featured in a Hollywood or other English-speaking movie. Today, I'd like to talk to you about 8 movies where Polish or elements of Poland are featured. Let's be honest, it's rare to hear Polish in a Hollywood movie. So I'm curious if you too have ever noticed any of these. Let's get right into it. The very first time I ever realized that Polish was being spoken in a Hollywood film was back in the 1993 movie The Fugitive with Harrison Ford and Tommy Lee Jones. I truly adore this movie and I've probably watched it at least a dozen times. Even though I know the ending, it always keeps me on the edge of my seat somehow. But for those of you that are Polish or speak Polish and have seen the movie, you likely know exactly where I'm going in the scene here where Harrison's character, Dr. Richard Kimball, rents out a room in a Polish area of Chicago. And I have to admit, I like this little nod to Chicago's old Polish community. Here you go.
Plenty space. You can look at. Co myślisz? Ja myślę, że on będzie zadowolony z tego. So, you like the place? It's okay with you?
The second movie I have to mention is one that I bet you've seen a time or two, and it's called Under the Tuscan Sun with Diane Lane. In this film, Diane Lane's character decides to buy a small house she falls in love with in Tuscany that needs total renovation. She hires an Italian-led construction company whose workers all come from Poland. Here are a few of my favorite scenes from that movie.
Miss, we are not Italian. We are from Polonia.
Poland? Do you all speak English?
Only me, and only a little. Oh. I am Paweł.
Oh, Paweł. Nice to meet you. Buongiorno.
Jerzy.
Jerzy. Hello.
Zbigniew.
Francis.
Kurwa match.
Kurwa match means holy shit in Polish. I learned that day. The fact that I'm trying to speak Polish in Italy is just one of the many surprises around here.
Czesław Miłosz.
I like him. Czesław Miłosz.
Oh, one more. And for those of you that have seen Under the Tuscan Sun, please tell me that this scene right here where the Polish construction crew has finished its job and is leaving doesn't touch you a little bit emotionally. It gets me. Let's take a look at this one.
Dziękuję.
Dziękuję.
For our third movie, my kids and I decided to give 1997's Home Alone 3 a try this Christmas. I did my best to warn them that the movie isn't nearly as good as the first two Home Alones, but they didn't listen to me as usual. I think the biggest reason to watch this film, though, is to see one of the burglars screaming at Alex, the new Kevin, to give him back his stolen disc. Have you seen this scene? It's short and sweet, but it's there.
Rozwinięte cię jak karalucha! Gdzie jest dysk?
I'm going to squash you like a cockroach, he says. Scary. For movie 4, we can't forget to mention the 2011 movie Water for Elephants, starring Reese Witherspoon, Robert Pattinson, and Christopher Waltz. I get a kick out of seeing Pattinson and Waltz use their best Polish in the movie and, you know, giving orders to the elephant who only responds to Polish commands. Pattinson was quoted as saying that having to act using the Polish language was extremely challenging for him. I can understand. In the movie, he actually had to sing a Polish lullaby in one scene, but unfortunately, it was eventually cut out of the movie. In any event, here are a few of my favorite scenes where Polish shows up.
Inside our house, there was no sign of a depression. My mother and father had left Poland in much worse condition. To them, nobody could be poor in America if they had half a brain in their head.
Jakub! Pożegnaj się! Kocham cię.
Do widzenia.
O dzień, Jakub. Jestem z tebe dumny.
Lift your leg. Podnieś nogę. Połóż nogę.
I want you to read these out loud to Rosie. Say, prosię, podnieś nogę.
What does that mean?
Just try it.
Prosię, podnieś nogę.
Połóż nogę.
Połóż nogę.
Módlmy się.
Módlmy się.
For our fifth movie, we have to talk about a movie called Sophie's Choice from back in 1982, starring Meryl Streep and Kevin Kline. Now, this is a highly emotional movie, but I've talked to several Poles here who've seen the film, and they have nothing but praise for Meryl Streep speaking Polish. I'm no expert, but I also think she does a fine job. Let's take a look at a sample of her Polish. I think you'll agree it's not too bad.
Nie mogę. Nie mogę narażać dzieci.
Twoje dzieci mogą być następne.
Nie chcę być w to wmieszana.
Our next movie, number 6, may not qualify as a typical Hollywood film, but it is a Polish-American movie that I think everyone should see who professes to love Poland. It's a little movie from back in 2008 called Mała Wielka Miłość, or Expecting Love in English. I will not spoil the movie for you, but the film stars American actor Joshua Leonard and Polish actress Agnieszka Grochowska. I'll only tell you that Joshua Leonard is somehow compelled to leave his lavish life as a hotshot Los Angeles lawyer to move to Warsaw and reunite with his love interest played by Agnieszka Grochowska. Let's just say that he goes through a lot of the same difficulties and challenges that I did when I moved here years ago, and I found the scenes both comforting and hilarious. Here's my favorite scene of Leonard's character at a Polish police station in Warsaw after having his baggage stolen, and he's making a report for stolen luggage.
Dokumenty, ma pan? Dokumenty.
Sir, I have a Polish-English phrase book. This is the only document that I have left because as I've been trying to explain...
Cicho. Się załatwi. Mm-hmm. Moment. Czy ktoś tu zna angielski? English.
English? Ja znaję. Oczy хорошо.
Chodź no tu. Siadaj. Siedź. Chodź tu.
Tuż. Hi.
Teraz. Zapytaj go, co się stało.
Значит, что случилось, да?
No da.
What happened to you?
Okay, the taxi drove away with my passport and my wallet and my suitcase.
On сказал, что ему кто-нибудь забрал чемодан.
Чемодан?
Walizkę.
A, walizkę. No tak. Co było w walizce?
Whose suitcase was it?
It was mine. It was my suitcase.
Jego. Jego.
Aha. Moment.
Yeah.
Czy ktoś to zna rosyjski?
I love it. For movie 7, has everyone seen the 1998 movie City of Angels with Nicolas Cage and Meg Ryan? Of course you have. But you may not have noticed that the intense music that's being played while Cage's character is falling features the Polish prayer called Zdrowaś Mario, or Hail Mary. You have to listen carefully, but here it is. Now, our final film, number 8, sadly has no Polish-speaking scenes at all. Sorry to mislead any of you. However, it does feature Vince Vaughn, who in a few of his movies has always gone out of his way to promote Poland. If you've seen the movie The Breakup, for instance, starring Vince Vaughn and Jennifer Aniston, you'll see a lot of love thrown Poland's way. Now, I did a little research on Vince, and it turns out he has no Polish blood whatsoever. I was 100% sure he was Polish somehow. And if you've seen the movie called The Delivery Man, Vaughn plays a character named David Wozniak, or David Wozniak. It's really fascinating to me, and I have to get to the bottom of this mystery. Anyway, let's take a look at what I'm talking about right here from The Breakup movie. And Vince, if you're watching by any chance, I would sincerely love to personally show you around Częstochowa. I'll be your tour guide, and I would love an interview with you. Just shoot me an email, okay? Here you go.
You and the get along gang leave, or I'm gonna throw you out of here personally.
Selling a condo is ludicrous.
I was waiting for when I was gonna get the house. Gary always screws his wife.
Old and loaded with talent.
Because I think I'm good enough to figure out how to.
Well, those were 8 films that really stood out to me when it comes to the Polish language in Hollywood or other English-speaking movies. Did I leave anything out? Did I miss any big ones? If so, educate me. Tell us in the comments section. Want to thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Click the button right about here so you don't miss out. I'll see you in the next episode.